guys, Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille career, where last time I left off, I had another infuriating outing with the second team. Well, on the flip side, my first team did the job they needed to get done. But this episode, as you can see, comes their toughest test yet. PSG, the current Ligue 1 champions and the dominators of French football in real life. Apparently, no one can beat PSG in real life. If I beat them, I will be 7 points clear. Now, PSG will have the man himself, Zlatan. Because when I updated the squad, for some reason, it didn't put him to Manchester United. You know how it works. It's the same reason Batshuayi and co are still here at Marseille. If you ask me, having Ibra in this match will make it even better. Because when I beat PSG, they will have no excuses. But one thing that does confuse me, normally this match would be December. This is in October. Which makes me think that this is not the match that the game is going to try and trip me up on. Even though PSG are currently second. Although, if I beat them, they could fall all down to third, maybe even fourth. Depending on results elsewhere.
Hello everybody. I'm Martin Tyler, alongside
of course, the park, the punts.
It should be a cracker today. Really looking forward to it.
Not only PSG's home, but the home of the French national team as well.
With the investment from the Middle East, Marseille have got their hands full.
There you see the. Oh no, Saint Etienne can go above them. Rennes can't. Rennes have already played. So PSG could only fall down to third.
Paris Saint-Germain, this is their line.
If and when I beat them.
Plays with Thiago Silva as the center backs.
And Ibrahimovic isn't playing. Maybe it did put him to Manchester United. Although saying that, Mkhitaryan is in the PSG lineup, and if it put Ibra to United, then it surely would put.
For Marseille, Steve Mandanda starts in goal.
Hanoglu
starts, looking to continue his great form in.
It would put Mkhitaryan there as well. For them at the front. Although, I don't know what's going on. The fans have been. Maybe Ibra was on the bench. I just didn't notice.
Game. It does leave them vulnerable times, but
if he is.
The opposition.
David Luiz.
Oh sure. Where's Cavani?
Angel Di Maria.
I have no idea who the dude they have on is.
He's cut out that.
Never freaking heard of him.
He read the mind of the opponent. Angel Di Maria.
PSG fans, if there are any in the comment section below, let me know. Who is this player who's playing up front for you? In this match,
jostle the opponent off his stride.
And, if Cavani and Ibra are on the bench, they must not be in good form. If that's the case, it's the only reason I can think of that they would be dropped. If, or maybe they were sold and I just didn't notice. Or like I said, maybe it did put Ibra to. Manchester United just didn't put Mkhitaryan. I don't know. I don't know what this game has done and what it hasn't done. It hasn't completely updated the transfers, but it might have put Ibra. I don't know. Mkhitaryan was pretty much confirmed before Ibra.
Now Tweedy. Mendy. Has blown and he's given the free kick.
I was gonna say Matuidi got away with that. but he didn't. Foul was indeed given. And the wheel, of course, coming up against his former teammates. Not that he would have been playing in this match anyway, it would have always been Aurier. Although, Aurier got into a bit of trouble with PSG in real life, so I don't know who the star right back for them is now. Maybe it is Granderil. Who keeps the ball in. Ah, the cross is blocked and PSG have a chance to counterattack, but they've wasted it. Diarra goes for it. He hits his own player. He hit Fletcher. Oh, Fletcher didn't get his fat ass in the way. Diarra might have actually scored. It might be 1-0. It's the most unlikely of goal scorers. He could do. Avoid the challenge is against Aurier. Me, Thiago. Yes. Oh, Thiago Silva got enough on it to make the shot not as dangerous as it would have been had there been no deflection. Might have given Trapp more of a test had there been no deflection. Oh my God! Punch pretty much off the line. Run the wheel. Goes for a goal! Oh, imagine in the scenes. Oh, Bashawa, he wins the ball off of Maxwell's mistake. Oh, Fletcher, surely, there we go. 1-0 just before halftime. Name Stephen Fletcher. Get in. And the away fans go wild.
A goal there to really savour for all of us watching. The keeper's pulled off a really good save.
Almost a disappointment that there was no handballs on there, because it clearly struck the hand of former Chelsea defender David Luiz. But it falls to Fletcher and he puts it in anyway, so it's 1-0 either way.
Could be the trigger for this game, the catalyst for change.
And that is a fantastic end to the first half.
Now it's exciting, they've got the goal.
If you ask me.
Force the opposition out, they've got to show the hand a bit more.
A lot of financial resources behind this game, Paris Saint-Germain. At the moment, the backers will be thinking that...
Now, if I can somehow sneak in a second before that... Half. I don't think I will, though, considering they have the ball. Well, that would be essentially very difficult. Although, hang on. Diarra. Someone get in the box. Bashawai is there. It is 2-0. Bashawai doubles the lead right before the halftime. Even later than the Fletcher goal. Oh. And once again,
restarting at 2-0.
A double punch. He package gives me a big lead at half time. Fantastic.
It's the second half we're going to study now, which is underway with Marseille leading. Maxwell.
And so far in this career mode, I've scored most of my goals in the first half. But I would like to, if possible, get one, maybe two more just to see PSG fully off. Because, you know, PSG are always going to be a threat, especially if they have Ibra or Cavani lurking. Or hell, both. Why not both? I mean, they could easily have both. I don't know. I only briefly looked at their starting lineup. I didn't pay any attention to Iron Robin. That I'll pay attention to. Former Chelsea and Bayern Munich man.
Paris Saint-Germain. They'll be facing apparently away from home.
Yeah, it's an important tie for both sides.
They have a lot of offensive.
There's no doubt about that.
They have wing options, but where is Ibrahim Cavani?
Wasn't quite the goal. I think the keeper might have been relieved there, Martin, because I don't think he would have got there.
I still don't get why they're both not playing. I mean, I can understand if one was sold, but both? Both and not replaced? I can't see PSG having... I mean, I know they got... Ibra didn't redeem his contract. So they might be looking for a new striker. They probably got him, and I just didn't hear who it was. As far as I know, they didn't get anyone to replace Ibra yet. I'm talking now in real life. But they still have Cavani there. But if Cavani was to leave, as some sources are saying constantly, because they're always saying that Cavani wants to leave, and nothing ever comes of it. But if PSG did sell both, I can't see them not replacing them with someone. Especially with their money. I mean, they could buy whoever they fucking want.
Very straightforward save for the goalkeeper.
So the fact that they haven't brought whoever they did, who have on yet, is a bit surprising. Maybe they're getting ready to bring him on. Here we'll see what happens. Yeah, they're bringing someone on.
They've decided to make a change.
No, it's Lucas. It's another white human. I mean, you can't and say PSG don't have a
good work by the goalkeeper.
A lot of wide men, but they have no one up front. What the hell? Who's playing at striker? I don't even know who the guy is who's playing at striker for PSG. And apparently, both Cavani and Ibra are sitting on the bench, and one of them isn't going to get on, if not both of them, because there's pretty much no time left. Is the computer going to bring them on when it's too late? When it's too late for them to make a real difference? I mean, if I am, if I was doing a PSG remote, I would definitely have them both on from the start. If this is bring on Ibra or Cavani, it's too late. It's not. They're bringing on Rabiot. And no offense to Rabiot, he's a great player. But if they do still have Cavani and Ibra, even if they still only have one of them, they've not brought either of them on. Or who have they got to replace them? Unless they didn't get someone to replace them. Which is crazy and stupid. How are they second?
And,
like, their wide men must be carrying them on this striker who I've never heard of. I've never fucking heard of him. But he must be amazing if he's carrying his G. Hey? Maybe I should sign him for the second team.
Iron Robin.
There's the full-time whistle. I've beaten PSG. They are 7 points behind. And whether they had Ibra and Cavani here or not is irrelevant. And there's one way to see who they did have. No, wait, this won't tell me. Why did I think this would tell me? Damn, that's disappointing. So, PSG pretty much threw away that match.
Liga earn L'Oréal.
And yeah, Saint-Étienne, no surprise, have overtaken them.
Montpellier 0. Nice 2. Nantes 2. Paris Saint-Germain 0. Olympique Marseille 2. Caen 1. Saint-Étienne.
This is gonna bother me if I don't check it.
That means for the league table.
What the hell? At the top of the table, going on over PSG?
Marseille with 27 points. In second, climbing the table are Saint-Étienne with 22 points.
Wait,
In third and falling are Paris PSG with 20 points.
Position
fourth,
attack.
A with 18 points. In fifth,
no, Ibra is still there. Is he injured? Points. Oh, he's injured.
L'Oréal with 40
well, that makes sense for Ibra. Cavani is gone.
With 13 points.
This is the guy who they had up front.
Lille with
Otenga.
Bottom of the table, Toulouse with 5 points. And then
I mean,
the table,
maybe he's good, I don't know.
Stade de Reims with 5 points. Third bottom, Angers with 6 points. Fourth bottom, Troyes with 6 points.
Well, that makes more sense. Ibra's in, Jordan Cavani is gone. That's why they didn't have anyone up front. He must have just gotten injured. Hurt, because PSG... He would have to have someone in scoring them goals. Yeah, Ibra has... Well, he only has two. Who else is scoring goals for him? Come on, PSG have scored 13 goals, 11 of which haven't been scored by Ibrahimovic. Who scored them? I know I'm obsessing over this, but this doesn't make any sense. How are they third when they don't have a recognizable striker? That makes no sense. I don't know why I'm looking at my short list. It's not like I'm gonna find the answer in there. Team stats. That's PSG. Maybe Cavani score a lot of goals before he... No, that guy did. He has scored 2 goals. Oh, no, wait. Somebody else. Oh, it wasn't... Oh, I'm getting my guys confused. 2 goals and an assist. Not bad. Maybe I should look at this guy. Maybe he's a prospect. Mkhitaryan has 2. Pastore has 2. Di Maria 1, Robin 1, Rabiot 1, Tui 1, and Lucas 1. Four twos is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, so that makes sense. Okay, so those are their goal scorers. This Eduardo. He might be someone to keep an eye on. Possibly. Get rid of that. Because... Unable to patch the leak. Wait, what? Yeah, he's who I got to replace. He's Remy Cabella. I don't even know who this guy is. Do you? I don't even think he plays with the second team. Brad or something. No, he doesn't. So, yeah, you can piss right off whoever you are. Yeah, stop their game. I need to do my training. And you can smell it. Really, Sporanga? You couldn't go up to 72? Prick. No, I don't want to manage any international team. Get that through your head. Laurent are sixth. Should be an interesting one. Whoa, look how blunt this dude is. Seven. I don't know any of the Laurent players, so I'm not gonna hazard a guess who it is. It's definitely not this guy, because this guy is 12. Ah, oh, bollocks! if that happened to me in a real penalty situation, I'd be super pissed. Expert comment on this game from the French First Division. It's like whoever he is, he's a looks like he's a central midfielder. Pick Marseille's lineup, Steve. This could be a shall I go straight away? Off the post! That would have been a fantastic start. It might still will happen. Oh, went for the finesse and just couldn't get it into the net. Chug, who's come out of the box shooting with a freaking mission or something. Hitting the post and just get shooting wide. Within a minute or so of the first instant. Third time is the charm. Who does not mess up this time, and he does indeed make it 1-0.
And that is a wonderful side foot.
Lovely 1-2 with Bashawa. He could have passed it to Fletcher or gone himself, but he gave it back to Chanelogu, who did not miss the third time. He nestled it right in the back of the net, and it is 1-0. Fantastic. I think that's 6 league goals for Chalaglu now. Might be more. To be honest, I probably completely lost count.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Here's a good defensive work there by my defender to make sure that the ball got up to where it needed to go. Oh, I my goalkeeper safely. Ashwai cross isn't good enough. It's come to Chalaglu. Oh, he did. He took a touch, kind of like the a flick or some shit. It kind of hit his heel and then rolled into the keeper's hand. Avoid that if possible all for the rest of the season, okay? He hacking Diarra Bashawai Tovan whip it in Fletcher. It's not gonna count, mate. You're offside. I saw the flag go up.
Well, the lad took it well, but quite rightly the linesman.
Although I think it was Tovan who was offside. To be fair to Fletcher. Ashwai keeps the ball. Oh, it's come back to Chanoglu and he's blown it completely wide. Why did I shoot? It was his seventh. That was kind of close.
Moving on to it, he was never going to whack it, and it was a composed finish from him.
Gregory van der Veel.
Van der Veel.
Tovan. Past one defender.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woeful.
Chalago can't make it 2-0 with a pretty bad header, to be fair.
Florian Tovan.
Tovan. Fletcher can't get the right connection on the header. Apparently he committed a foul of some kind. Maybe he was offside, I don't know. Michy Batshuayi. Batshuayi. Go.
Excellent play too. Losing
oh. Good clean shot. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. At least he gets a corner out of it. Credit to the keeper for a fantastic save, though.
And it will go into the middle now.
Whoa, did I keep that in? Freaking hell. I thought that was gonna go straight over my player's head. I did press square in case. Just in case.
That will be a throw for Marseille.
I couldn't keep it and take the throw quickly.
Benjamin Mendy. Oh, in goes the cross.
Who? Batshuayi? Are you freaking kidding me? The luck is not there. He hit the post. And the follow-up shot, he was never going to really score. It was a terrible angle. There's no one around for me to try and get to a teammate. The closest player would have probably been Fletcher or Çalhanoğlu. But I couldn't see anyone on screen. Yeah, good position. Fletcher! But Fletcher gets into good position. Anyway, and he makes it 2-0. Oh. Oh, again, just before halftime. Or right before the halftime whistle will go. This guy here in the middle thinks it was offside. The referees and the linesmen do not agree with him. And Stephen Fletcher's goal stands, and it's 2-0.
Restarting at 2-0.
Maybe he should spend less time focusing on what isn't offside and focusing on doing it on some defensive work. Oh, maybe a third goal. Toban, surely. Oh, come on. Yes, it went in anyway. He didn't even need to get another touch on it. It went in anyway.
Just enough to roll it past the goalkeeper. What's
a
the placement was so good.
I think you've got to be playing with an awful
what a bit of hijinks that was.
The goal, wherever you look at it, it was very well taken.
I wasn't sure if that was gonna go in or not. I think I stopped the defender getting there, or actually. E number 3. Watch number 3 here for Toven's goal. You see him going for it. Yeah, Toven actually stopped him from getting there. Or he might have actually gotten to it if I hadn't gone for a diving header and failed miserably with Toven. Because he dived right in front of the defender. I don't know if you're actually allowed to do that. Diving headers is one thing, but almost kind of looks like he threw himself down intentionally to stop the defender getting there to make sure the ball went in, and the keeper couldn't recover in time. It's an interesting one. I've never seen a goal quite like that. I've seen ones that trickle over the line despite the keeper getting a hand to it. But a player here that looks like he dived to prevent the defender
getting set
or having the chance to clear it? Looks a bit dodgy. And that's coming from his manager. So that tells you something. What the hell was that? What kind of cross was that? Oh, is that going to show it again? And watch this again. There we go. There he dives in front of the defender. And the defender's like, oh. Okay. He kind of gives up. He pretty much gives up and accepts that it's going to go in. And he might have actually gotten to it. Or at least he's almost gotten to it. It would have been a hell of a close call.
What about Lorient's next game?
Oh, had Toven not gone for the diving header? Failed miserably. I don't know. Is it because it's a diving He went for the diving header. Is that what
substitution in the offing?
Excuses him seemingly clearly diving right in front of the defender to prevent him getting to the ball.
Kanjo.
Again, I've never seen anything quite like that. I've never seen a player go for a diving header, look like he's completely dived intentionally right in front of the defender to prevent the defender getting to the ball. I mean, make your own minds up in the comment section below, but I did go for a diving header, but it looks like Tovan was trying to prevent the defender from getting to the ball. Oh, which, if you ask me, should go down, should result in a free kick out and the goal being disallowed. And this is coming from Tovan's manager. So, if I'm saying that, I want Marseille to do as well as anybody, but it almost looks like he did that deliberately, which I didn't. I really didn't. I did not mean for it to look like that. I was legit trying to go for a diving header and I completely missed. I mean, like I said, make your own mind up in the comments below and let me know if there's ever been anything like that before. As a player, gone for a diving header, or looked like he threw himself down in front of a defender intentionally after missing the diving header. I mean, I went for the diving header. I'm not gonna say I dived, because I don't think you can actually do an actual dive in this game.
The break is definitely on.
Except when you're going for a diving header, or if you're controlling the keeper for something like a
very good stop here.
A penalty. But when outfield player, except when you're going for diving headers, I don't think you can actually have a player actually do a an intentional dive, because if you could, they'd get booked straight away. Are you surely?
He tried his luck from a long way out, but the goalkeeper had no problems at all.
Plus, that would. I know diving, like, there was a way to dive before, but I think they removed it from the game. Maybe because everyone just turned it off, because, like, it,
time is very much the friend of Marseille in these circumstances.
For, because they didn't want it. I mean, don't get me wrong, I went for the diving header, I just completely failed at it. But it looks like Tovan threw himself down to stop the defender getting at the preventing the goal.
And that's dealt with the problem.
In his failed attempt to make sure the ball went in, Tovan made sure the ball went in by unintentionally. And I'm doing air quotes there. I have to say so because you can't actually see me. Unintentionally diving in front of the defender to prevent him getting to the ball.
Headed down to a teammate.
Like I said, make up your own mind. The game gave the goal. Well, it didn't see anything wrong with what Tovan did. It is a very strange incident, because if that's me, it almost looks like he did it intentionally to prevent the defender from stopping the ball going in. Which, if it is allowed, shouldn't be. And again, that's coming from his manager for this career mode. So, make of that what you will.
1. Olympique Lyonnais, 2. Saint-Étienne, 4. GFC Ajaccio.
Is Tovan a diver?
Lyon, 1.
Or is he just shit at diving headers? I mean, I failed at the diving header, I'll admit that.
Stade Rennais.
I went for a diving header. I completely fucking missed. But it looks like I had Tovan intentionally throw himself in front of the ball. Oh. And I like it saying he's the man in form. He might. He probably should be the man in trouble.
In second, Saint-Étienne
for being quite the neglecter of the rules.
Stade Rennais with 21 points. In fourth, moving down.
Think of it as you will. Oh.
In fifth, Monaco with 17 points.
Well, over the next few hours. Because that's the end of this episode. Make sure like this episode if you did enjoy. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any future episodes.
And then reading up the table, second bottom moving down are Angers.
Really?
With
did
six
that
points.
Really just happen? God damn it. Stupid computer.
Troy with 6 points.
Please ignore that. And yeah. I will see you all in the next episode.
Montpellier with
when
9
I
points.
Play Sampdoria. Huh? For a very interesting match. And I have my first League Cup game against Montpellier. So, it's all competition time tomorrow. So, don't miss it. Until then, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.